So without further ado, I'm pleased to welcome a good friend and mentor of mine, Roy. Yeah.
I want to start by saying thanks to Sam and Doug. I really don't know LA at all, so I've been here for maybe 5 days. So it's really cool to see the spot. It's dope. Good on you, big ups. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. You can also expect to see me here more often.
What the mic?
You can't hear me? Okay, my bad. This is better?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. Work at Plus. We've been a Bay Area company for the last 2.5 years, but we just got a certificate of occupancy up in a town called Adelanto in the high desert. So moving the factory down this week, we'll be moving the best members of my crew who are actually here, the Plus fam, moving them down as well. So we're really excited to be here, and it's like a great way for us to kind of kick off our launch. So thanks for having me. That being said, my background, like Sam said, look, the sales, it's all on Lucy, actually, who's here. She's my co-founder. Director of sales, and if you know Lucy, she's great. Not used to this. I'm a licensed lawyer and also a software developer. So I started with Plus sort of on the legal accounting operations side. Since then, we've grown enough that we have brought in law firms and accounting firms. So I've been able to transition for the last year and a half. I've been the director of manufacturing operations, and I'm also on the board of directors. We have grown steadily, like I said, but we are also sort of a classic startup pivot. We started actually with what Lance was talking about as a company that took advantage of the FinCEN guidance. We were gonna be kind of a ratings agency for banks to help them de-risk the industry. We didn't really think that was a long-term play, so wanted to get into the branded product space and started an edibles company. We have an international patent on a gum that nobody wants to buy, which is fine, but that was frustrating for a long time. So after about a year, we pivoted again and kind of struck gold with gummies. We didn't actually know that gummies were such a fast-growing vertical within edibles, but lo and behold, they are. So that was kind of serendipitous in that way. But we still have the gum and hope to someday bring it back. But as of right now, we're really focused on gummies. We've expanded with 7 different SKUs. We make a CBD gummy now that's hemp-derived. But something Kelsey was talking about that I deal with a lot now is the pesticide issue. So I can circle back on that later. Thing is, like, my style is more conversational, so if you want to like deep dive anything I'm talking about, I'd rather have it be useful for you guys than to be up here talking. But when I talked to Sam, he wanted me to talk about using processes to increase interdepartmental communication within a company. And I thought to myself, I used to speak at legal conferences and bore everybody, and that is. And now that I'm in the sexy cannabis industry, I can't believe that that's actually what he wants me to talk about. But I'm trying to make it exciting, or at least kind of introduce something, some useful tidbits. All right. If you can't hear me in the back and you start talking, I can hear you. That being said, I think it's an exciting time in the industry because there really aren't multinational companies that have sort of set the standard for how we do things. Everything is a startup in a sense. I mean, there are players that have been around longer, but in any event, they're all sort of a startup mentality. And I think that that's exciting, but I think that also innovation for innovation's sake can be destructive. As you scale, people don't really scale, that's what I've learned. Processes scale. So it is important to be thinking that way, I think, in terms of operating a cannabis business. And so we've intentionally at Plus, we're trying to be innovative on the R&D side, our food product side, our manufacturing techniques. We're also trying to actually borrow from other industries and apply them within our own departments. So that being said, for collaboration and communication, from tech, we've borrowed Slack. We use Slack, which is a great app. I don't know how familiar you guys are with it, but we run sales channels through the various numbers. We can check inventory, you know what time distributors are coming and picking up, for example. And you can kind of silo off communication that way, and I think that's useful. Kind of, it's like gamification, you might say, of email, so that you don't have all these long threads that you're searching through. Instead, it's more direct communication. We also use Google Apps for Business, right? So shared calendars, email, all that helps activity. It sort of makes communication natural as opposed to something where you're always reacting, you know, wherever you work, you know, who's out of the office today, whatever. And as you grow, that really becomes important because I don't even know two of the accountants, for example. So if they're out, I wouldn't even know one way or another unless they can check their calendar. All right, so on the sales side, we've got direct sales, but we also use distributors, so, you know, kind of borrowing approaches there, pounding the paper at the same time, using distributors to unlock doors. And this is where I can really nerd out, is like project management. We borrow a lot from tech. I had several startups, like Sam said, they all failed, but we'll say that you learn a lot from failure. I really believe that, at least if you're self-reflective enough to realize you made mistakes along the way. And so, you know, we borrow from things that we've learned. My co-founder used to work at Facebook, and so we use Trello. It's like a Kanban board. If you ever talked about it, you can use this. Asana is also a really good app. It helps interdepartmental communication. And then in manufacturing, that's where I'm at. So like I said, I can really nerd out here, but we use a Toyota manufacturing system. It was invented by Toyota. It's now called manufacturing. Lean is such a great term. Lean and agile, right? Every investor wants to hear this, but what does that mean? Like on our level, lean manufacturing really drives the entire factory. And what I mean by that is that it's a system, like a closed-loop system. And so we use that to input sales forecasts for the next 6 months so we know where we're heading because we're trying to scale up. And at the same time, use our bill of materials, which are essentially recipes with all the packaging and all the ingredients, and order that ahead of time so that we've locked in on the schedule. All that comes from this Toyota manufacturing system. And once that goes through, you gotta keep feeding the system on the back end and scheduling production correctly because the line, my line is great, right? They'll kill it. So, but if they outstrip our materials, we gotta shut down the line. Like, it's all balance, right? And so, there's a real beauty to the system, but I had to read 3 textbooks in 2 months to try to figure this out, right? So again, borrowing from other industries, trying to implement them ourselves. And I think that's important to keep in mind because we're probably all sort of involved in startups to some degree, right? And it's key to be a team member, really be invested in that early because it's all about the people. But if you're lucky enough to hit success and you get to scale up like that, you can't, like I said, you can't scale people. It doesn't work like that. No matter how hard the founders work, they can never work hard enough, right? So it's more about your team. More about having a team that's invested, understands where your company's headed, and all these communication tools help do that. So hopefully that gives you some interesting information about us. Happy to do Q&A or whatever.
Yeah, we have 3 minutes. Yeah, take 1 or 2 questions. Yeah.
Salesforce, have you used Salesforce on your sales side?
Good question. We've been talking about doing that recently. We want to go full ERP with like SAP. And I think Salesforce has an integration. Lucy, maybe you might have it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all right.
Anyone else? All right. Well, I'll be around and I'll be coming back. So next time.